Good morning everyone, myself Mrs. Neetu Soji. Today we are going to see some small topics in Medical Surgical Nursing 1 in the unit Management of Nursing with Gastrointestinal Disorders. Patients with Gastrointestinal Disorders. So in this session we are going to see two disease conditions, that is helminthiasis and constipation. So these are very simple topics, but you can get these questions. It is very small topics, but you can get these topics in short answers. So we will move on to the disease condition. The first one is helminthiasis. So what is helminthiasis? It is also known as worm infestation or worm infection. Okay, the body is infected with parasitic worms known as helminths. Helminths are classified into three types: tapeworm, roundworm and hookworms. So what is helminthiasis? It is nothing but worm infestation. Body mein jo parasitic organisms hai, theek hai, usme se jo infection humko milte hai, theek hai, wo parasitic organism ko hum kya bolte hai? Helminthus, theek hai. So these infestations, these worm infestations, we are termed it as helminthiasis. So we will see both the causes and the clinical manifestations of these helminthiasis, that is for alag alag organisms. For roundworm, what is the cause and what are the clinical manifestations, and hookworm, and also for the tapeworm. We can see in the first column it is given as the causes of roundworm infestation and hookworm and tapeworm infestation, and in the second column it is the clinical manifestations of the same disease. We will see what are the causes of roundworm infestation. The egg of roundworm, it contaminate the food, and larvae can go to the lungs and back to the intestine and produce more eggs. Actually these intestines, these parasites are there in our body intestine. ठीक है, so ये roundworm का egg क्या करते हैं, ठीक है, so it contaminate the food and these larvae, जब हम खाना खाते, ठीक है, so वो intestine में से कहाँ पे जाएगा, larva lungs में जाएगा, वहां से वापस intestine में आएगा. This is the cause of roundworm infestation. And what are the clinical manifestations of the same? You can see low grade fever, cough, blood stained sputum, wheezing, dyspnea, chest pain, pain in the abdomen and vomiting. This is about roundworm. And coming to the hookworm, the cause is the larva enter through the skin or by indigested food. So this is the cause. And coming to the clinical manifestation of hookworm infestation, there will be abdominal pain, cough, itching in the skin, that is in, especially in the lower limbs, then anorexia, diarrhea, anemia and pallor. These are the clinical manifestation. In tapeworm infestation, the tapeworm infestation will occur by eating uncooked meat. So the clinical manifestations will come as nausea, vomiting, then abdominal pain, diarrhea and weight loss. So these are the causes and clinical manifestation of roundworm, hookworm and tapeworm infestations. What are the diagnosis we will do to evaluate these disease conditions? We will do stool examination for the evaluation of the presence of ova or parasite. We will do complete blood count and serological testing also we will do. So what are the management? There will be deforming treatment, that is tablet mebendazole single dose for 3-day course given to the patient. The dose can be repeated every 2 weeks. Everyone know for worm infestation we are giving tablet mebendazole, and tablet albendazole is more effective for hookworm infection. And if the patient is having anemia, we will give tab ferrous sulfate 200 mg TID daily for anemic patient. So what are the treatment? The main treatment, matlab hum jo commonly jo follow karte hai, wo tablet mebendazole hai, single dose एक दिन में एक डोज फॉर 3 डेज, ठीक है, एंड इट कैन बी रिपीटेड एवरी 2 वीक्स. एंड टैब एल्बेंडाजोल वी आर गिविंग मेनली फॉर, एंड इट इज मेनली इफेक्टिव फॉर हूपबॉर्न इन्फेस्टेशन. एंड इफ द पेशेंट इज हैविंग एनीमिया वी विल गिव टैब फेरोसल्फेट 200 mg TID, दैट इज 3 times a day. What are the nursing management? We can advise the patient to prevent infection by using standard precautions, that is hand washing and hygiene, disinfecting the toilets. Advise the patient to wash hands prior to eating and after going to toilet. Advise the patient not to consume raw vegetables and uncooked meat. Advise to wash all fruits and vegetables before cooking. And advise the patient to use safe water. So this is all about helminthiasis or worm infestation. We will move on to the next topic, constipation. What is constipation? Constipation is a condition in which there is difficulty in emptying the bowels, unusually associated with and usually associated with hardened feces. This is the definition of constipation. The causes are diet, drugs, there will be metabolic causes, muscular causes, then any structural and functional disorders, and there will be psychogenic constipation. The clinical manifestations include abdominal discomfort, anorexia, straining to pass stool, abdominal pain, nausea, and a palpable mass in the abdomen. What are the complications? It can be occurred due to constipations. There will be hemorrhoids, perforation, it can cause fever, abdominal pain and nausea and vomiting. Then there will be diverticulosis. So what are the diagnostic evaluations we can do? History and physical examination, abdominal x-ray, barium enema we can do, colonoscopy, sigmoidoscopy and rectal examinations. What are the management? To prevent and control, the special treatment for constipation is advise the patient to take highly fiber diet, then 6 to 8 glasses of water every day, then enemas we can give, then bulk forming drugs like methyl cellulose psyllium, stool softeners we can give, lubricants we can apply, stimulants we can give, and saline and osmotic solutions also we can give, then sodium. This saline and osmotic solution ka example hai milk of magnesia and sodium phosphates. Nursing management include advice to take high fiber diet, advise the patient not to suppress the urge of defecation. If the patient hesitate to use bedpan, we can provide bedside commode. Advise the patient to do abdominal exercise to improve peristalsic movement. Enema we can give, and aid medication should be given as prescribed. And advise the patient to take warm glass of water after getting up in the. So this is all about helminthiasis and constipation. It's very simple topic, very short topic, but you can get 4 short answers. Write the notes, study it. Thank you.